What? Okay. Keycard!
So that's it. The last one.
Yes!
Let's plug this in and get the fuck out of here. I can feel the Rad-X wearing off.
I hear you.
Okay, that's odd. Says the stash is in the Vegas ruins. Fiend territory.
Oh god, not Vault 3.
Well, after fighting through Fort Zombie, the fiends will be nothing. Now let's get out of here before I start shitting plutonium.
Okay. If we ever go back to Good Springs and visit my home, you are not allowed to use the toilet.
Yippee-yay, there'll be no wedding bells.
And we're back. And that's just wrong, isn't it? That really is. That's just wrong. However, we're still basically stood in a radiation pit. We have found the location of... Let's have a look. We have found the location of the stash. And apparently it's Vault 3. But we needed these keys anyway to get in there. So there must have been a hidden... There you go. Inside the Las Vegas arsenal. So obviously we needed the keys to get in there anyway. But we're going back to Vault 3, which is annoying on so many levels. We never really have a very good time there, do we? So, did I loot everything in here?
Hey, I might have seen that flick. I had that guy with the mustache. Dr. Something. It was some kind of sci-fi musical. Fucking weird.
I love this guy. Right, I think we're supposed to go this way, Bradley. Elevator to Outpost Lambda Level 2. I think this is the quick way out. Yes! And... silence, which means I can get this silly yellow suit off. You know, get the important things. I want my hat on. Definitely want my hat on. I want my glasses on. I got my flashlight on. And finally, clothes. I did them in order of importance. So there you go. Right. Did we loot everything here? Apparently not everything, no. I believe I dropped quite a few laser rifles, but I've been... Let's have a look. Laser rifles. It's the plasma disruptors that I'm... Oh, they're not worth it. They're not worth it. Stop picking them up, I think is the... I promised myself I wasn't going to pick them up. Let's get out of here. Elevator to Outpost Lambda. Okay, so. Are we done? Yay! Completely! Okay, I don't have many. Let's go back to the van and get some ammunition, but when we go out of here. Because I don't trust this syndicate to not suddenly appear and go, hello! Nope! Okay. Alright, guys.
I've got your back.
Everyone follow. So, where the hell are we going? Data. Roadmap. Back to... the fort. Neutral. Isn't that where, that's where Caesar is, isn't it? That's where Benny is. I have to get there and get the key... Platinum chip, sorry. Right, we're off to the Bitter Springs recreational area, which is in that direction. And oddly enough, we didn't have much trouble getting here. I'd like to assume that means I won't have much trouble getting back. Is it kind of sad that I won't pick up things that are worth sort of 800 caps because it's just not worth it now? But I'm stopping to loot absolutely everything that I can cook food with. That's probably a little weird, isn't it? That's almost certainly weird. Yeah. Still. There you go. I think we made it. And without... Hello. without any trouble. Which definitely worries me. Should check I'm wearing the right gear. Okay. Not running around the wasteland in a bright yellow rubber suit. Okay. Never mind. Now, before I go anywhere, I'm actually going to make some ammo. Wait, what did I just discover? What did I just discover? Okay, that was weird. Right, I was going to say that I need to make some ammo, and then the nearest place to Vault 3 is Camp McCarran. We're going to park outside. No, inside Camp. Actually, is inside Camp McCarran the best place, or West Free? No, it's too far. No, Camp McCarran it is. But first of all, oh god, this is where I really. Reloading bench. Crafting options. Can I go straight to? No. Craft now. That's one of. This is going to be really irritating to do lots of crafting with these guys. Could everyone just sort of? Really? Yes. I need a bigger van. So I need Bradley to go over. There.
Roger that.
And I need Eddie to do the same thing. Alright, Eddie, go there then. Okay, nice. Okay, brilliant. That's a little irritating, isn't it? Now, I think 70. No, let's go for 80. I think I'm going to use the shotgun more. When you look at my ammo usage, yeah, I think 80 is probably. See, I barely used any of these. Interiors, and we're going in interior again. Honestly, I think my sniper rifle, I probably at the moment, what I want to do is leave the anti-material rifle off the, let's have a look, put that back on, and the evening redress here. I'm almost never going to use this weapon. This is such a. It's like I'm going to be outside and I'm going to need to shoot some death claws. I actually think I should leave this with Eddie or one of the guys. But I've taken minimal amount of ammo on this, enough to kill several death claws. I've got some normal ones and I've got some explosive ones. For this, I've got enough to kill entire villages. But again, I don't. Same with this. Between these two, I could have a small invasion. But look how little I used. This is what I use. In interiors, and this to some degree. We'll have a few of these. But honestly, I think, more than anything, it's the shotgun. So, I'm going to need to take extra ones of those. In fact, you know what? Let's make 10 more of the shotguns. Now, someone said to me, I shouldn't use these, because although they do more damage, they have less chance of the knockback with the perk I've got now. But I'm okay with that. I think I've got I'm over-encumbered. See, I've now got a lot of bullets on that. And I'm now over-encumbered. I probably should leave some ammo. Okay, I'm going to have to sort my ammo out. Actually, worrying about ammo is probably immaterial, considering the other stuff that I'm carrying. So I think what I should do is go and sell some of. That's what I was going to do anyway, wasn't I? I was going to wander off and I'll call in the gunrunners first. It's on the way. I'm calling the gunrunners because I do have a few items to sell them. All right, doing that. Gunrunners first. Okay, picked up a couple of mods on my. I don't know what an embedded laser sight is or a cryo revolver extended barrel is. Actually, I suspect I know what that is. I don't have a cryo revolver yet. Nobody seems to sell one, which is unfortunate, because it sounds very cool. And I got even more caps out of it. Now, I tell you what else I want to do. I want to go off and. You guys need to follow me now.
I've got your back.
I want to go to the medical center. The closest place to that was the Crimson Caravan, wasn't it? I believe it was the Crimson Caravan. Yep, okay. Let's go and see about implants. Might be some more implants on the dock. And I've got the money now. Okay, let's see what she's got in the way of implants.
Because you're a friend of the followers, I can give you a bit of a discount.
Yay, I'm a friend of... Why am I a friend of the followers? What? When did that happen? Cat eye. I can make cat eye. I don't need to buy cat eye. I'm not going to waste the money. I can make doctor's bags as well now, so I might as well take some. I've got loads of those, I don't know about the rest. Superstem, Kim, new, yada yada. Oh, this is everything. You don't have any... Really? You don't have any parts at all. You're useless. Really? Completely useless. And I don't think I've got enough parts, enough, let's have a think. On the implants, to get the other perks, for example, I need all of one area. So I've got neural data tool and razor nail implants. The only one I've got at the moment are the leg. I've got the perk for the leg because I've got all of the implants for the leg. I've got data tool implant and hyperfrequency emitter, which I believe... Let's have a look. I'd like to perform.
Very well.
What have I got? I've got... Plus one intelligence and... Voice modulator. I think I need all of the ones from Project Nevada to get the... I don't think you need the special ones. I'm pretty sure you don't. And then you get the ability to have four implants in your head. Same with the arm. Currently I've got the neural data tool and the kinetic accelerator. I've got the razor tools. What else is there actually? Tread damp. See, I've got this one already. I'm tempted to take out all of my implants and see if I get any more perks, because that's when I get the perks. And it doesn't really cost me a huge amount anyway, so... Alright, you know what? I'm going to do that. I'm going to remove all of my implants. That's for that, that's for that, that's for... If you don't know what I'm doing, there is some perks you get for having all of one type of cybernetic thing in your inventory. Which is kind of cool. Oh, I can also upgrade my implants, can't I? Because I've got good science skill now. I've actually got good science skill. Have you got a... You know what? I should... Yes, this is probably not going to be as much use as I thought. I need the implants that are in my legs. I wanted to take all the implants out, and then I'm going to see if I can upgrade them my awesome science skill now.
Very well.
Okay, I need... Basically, I need 80. I need 80. I also need a steam gauge assembly. I've got one of those. I've got at least 10 of those in the van. It mustn't be on the list somewhere. All right. I need skill of 80, but I don't think I can do that. I think I can do that. Let's find that steam gauge. For some reason, it's not showing up as part of the inventory, but I have got a load of them. Steam gauge assembly. There you go. I knew I had them. Right, let's have a look at what I can do. I need five, and then one book. What have I got here? I've got loads of really good. I've got party time mentats, plus two intelligence, plus four intelligence from these mentats, which should then give me the skill. Science 71, and then I just use a... Programmer's Digest, and now have Science 81! Oh god, I hope it lasts long enough for me to upgrade all of them. I can do some of the other ones as well, that's interesting. Alright, let's get the ones that need 80 first, just in case I do run out of time and have to keep using all these things. Neural data implant.
Do you need medical attention?
Okay, so yeah, got them all upgraded. I didn't get any perks though, so I want to buy an implant.
Which surgery option are you considering?
Which ones do I not have? Luckier, regenerating ability? That would be nice, actually.
That's the Phoenix Monocyte Breeder. The implant speeds up cell regeneration, an effect similar to that of some lizards and sea creatures.
Actually, that sounds
really
good.
The implant is very expensive, however. 12,000 cash.
Nothing. Chump change. Here you go.
Very well.
I love being rich. I want to buy an implant.
Which surgery?
Let's have a look what you got. Strength, perception, endurance. Charisma could be useful. Yeah. Can you make me luckier?
If I implant the probability calculator in the frontal lobe, you'll be able to calculate odds a little better.
Whatever.
It's not quite the same as making you luckier, but you'll be able to nudge things your way more often. I can do the implant for 4,000 caps.
You had me at it makes you luckier, so
very well.
And what else? Charisma made me more charming. Could always help, but I've got that one that adds speech, which is nice. And although it lets me take more followers, to be honest with you, I've already got too many. I'm thinking of getting rid of one while I've got Bradley. So, endurance.
The nociception regulator modifies.
Blah, 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 blah. Here's the money.
Very well.
I want to buy an implant. Blah, blah, blah. More blah. Perception. Just to tell you what. Give me everything you got. And I'll decide what I want when I want it. Okay. Okay, now I've got everything. I got absolutely everything. I've got a full set here.
Very well.
Did I just get a message? Programmer's digest worn off. Something about... Let's have a look. Did I get any more perks? That would be nice. Is that what I had to do? Get all those? I had Cyperlimbic. That's the one I've got. And... I think that's all I've got. I don't think I got any others there. Nope. Anyway, let's...
You're back.
Give me the cybernetics.
Very well.
I tell you what, I really do want more kinetic accelerators because I like them in my arms and my legs. I've got weight absorbers and tread dampeners for now, which makes me good at sneaking. Oh, right. So this makes me good at sneaking, which, yeah, is always nice, but I'd rather have the one that makes me faster. And can carry more, obviously. But I'm saving the kinetic, I think, for the arm. Mind you, I've got a lot more options now. The neural data tool gives me plus 10 science. Don't want that. Hyperfrequency emitter lets me... That's a weird one. So when it comes down to it, it is kinetic accelerator implant. Gives me a better bullet time. And this one, razor tool, unarmed critical, I never really hit anything, do I? Neural data tool, plus 7 science? Sure, why not? Then for this, I've been using the synthetic lungs, which are nice, but I want the subdermal armor because it makes me harder to kill. And I kind of want the... Right, here's the thing, the synthetic lungs were... 25% less drain on sprint, and I got water breathing, which was nice. What the hell's this one? Hypertrophy accelerator? Strength plus 1. Synthetic lungs. Which one's this? Endurance would be useful, wouldn't it? Endurance would be really, really useful. Regulator implant, No, we're not that one. Where's the one? Breeder. I regain health. That's... I bought it for 12,000. I kind of want to work. I want to use it. But in actual fact, I've got so many chems now. And it can even repair damaged limbs. Still, oddly enough, for all the fact that I've just spent a bunch of money on it, I'm actually not convinced it's the most useful... I've got to tell you, I actually think the one that reduces the drain on my stamina when sprinting is kind of useful for generally, because I do so much running around. And beyond that, then actually endurance, I think. Now, let's try the one that regenerates, just for giggles. We're going to try the one with health regeneration and see what it does for us. So we've got arms, chest, head. We've not done head yet. Ooh. Right. Plus one luck. Now, I did have the voice modulator, which gave me barter and speech. So, obviously, my barter and speech are going to take a hit here. Logic coprocessor. This was the one that gave me intelligence. I've been using that one. Perception would be nice. And empathy. But I think logic and luck. Intelligence and luck. Thank you very much. Alright, so I've now got a whole new setup. I'd like to check out what my speech and barter skills are now. Because I actually put that implant in so that I could convince someone at the Helios site. I don't know if you remember. special perception. Oh, I don't need a perception anyway. Do I even need intelligence? My intelligence was pretty high. I should have checked before I installed the Science 81 now. Not bad. Oh, I believe I'm under the influence of chems. Right, yeah. Look, 8. Nice. Skills. Barter is down to 88. Oh, damn. Speech at 23. Right, yeah. So I've taken a bit of a hit there, but I'm now a little tougher. Okay. It is time to get on with this. I'll tell you what, let's get back to the van first of all. And I think I'm going to have some food, some sleep, and drive to McCarran. Okay, just catching up. Never mind. Oh, it's this. Sorry, my van's this way. Door. Okay, you know what? You spend a lot of time managing inventory and that type of thing in this game. Oops. Right, so I have now got myself sorted. Equipment sold, ammo made, had some food, some liquid, had some sleep. It is now 6:20 in the morning. Roughly, there you go. New implant so I can carry even more, and I'm even sneakier than I was previously. So I think we're prepared. I've got... I'll tell you what I couldn't do. I couldn't make any cat eye. I could not make cat eye. I don't quite know why. It wouldn't let me make cat eye on my stove in the van. So I need to figure out what... Do I need a special chem desk to make cat eye? I didn't think I did. I thought I could make them at cooking pots, but apparently not in my van. Which was disturbing. Am I carrying too much whiskey? 18 bottles of whiskey. Am I going to need 18 bottles of whiskey, do we think? Is that... That might be too many. I'll tell you what. There you go, we're carrying slightly less now. Right, well, we're ready. On our way! Come on, lads. That's just wrong, isn't it? Lads. Ladies and gents is better. Girls. Ladies. But lads. Too many males. We're going to have to fix that. It's just somehow wrong. Yeah, sometime soon we're going to go back to Good Springs. We're going to leave Eddie there for a little break and take Cass. I miss my drinking buddy. I can't really drink with that. Well, maybe Bradley. I can imagine Bradley's fun to drink with. Boom seems a little on the miserable side. And, you know, Eddie doesn't drink. So I miss Cass. She's kind of cool. You drink, and she drinks at the same time. I miss that. I miss drinking whiskey and hearing someone else go, that hits the spot. Well, there you go. Right, so we are on the way to...
Company.
Yes, indeed. Okay. This is why 3 followers is too much. Fire axe. Mind you, to be honest with you, let's face it, one fiend, even if I didn't have you guys, a fiend with a fire axe. Not exactly difficult. Oh, Bradley, Boone, meet strange, weird, pointy guy. I'd say you get used to it, but you kinda don't. It's just really weird, no matter what. No more weird than the rest of the things we're gonna meet, but for some reason, can't help but noticing it each time. So, actually, you know what? We might want to... Exactly. There could be fiends.
Oh, well.
Oh, yes, yes indeed. I love the slow-mo on the plasma. Okay. Piece of cake. This weapon's pretty damn good. One shot, one kill. Lever action rifle? Not really. Where was the other one? I mean, I'm guessing it's perfectly reasonable. This is a... What was the caliber on this again? Again, not a weapons expert. It uses 4570G, whatever that is. I'm assuming it's a big round. I'll take that. Because it does a lot of damage. I'm supposing most bullets really would kill someone dressed like that. Even a small pistol. But it's nice to, you know, make sure. Okay. Probably fiends. Almost certainly fiends. I don't suppose I could convince you guys to stay here. No. Am I even hitting? Okay, guys.
Sure.
Just wait here. That was a little on the overkill side.
I'll follow you.
Be passive. Stay here, for God's sake. These guys are ridiculous. Right. You're not coming into the vault with us. A. Here's the thing, they're kind of powerful, but they also do stupid things and are likely to get themselves killed. Probably due to the mods I've got installed, but they actually, my guess is I'd lose at least two of them if I went into Vault 3 with them. Even with the ridiculous level of damage they do. Okay. Excuse me a second. Okay, fix that. Slight issue with the, depth of field. Okay, there's people out here, but let's... Ooh, those things are worth quite a bit. Now, guys, stay in, stay passive, because I don't even trust you to be aggressive. I think we're going to have some more ahead. Does this mean the entire Vault 3 is going to have repopulated? It probably does, doesn't it? Makarov? Nothing. I know, I don't actually have to pick up any of this ammo anymore. I think I've now got enough of every type of ammo to last, well, a long time. However... Did we just pretty much kill every fiend that's in the neighborhood? Is that what happened? Okay. Come on then. We may have a couple more stragglers out here. Nope. Okay, so we're going in here. Let's just double check. Did he just try and sneak? He looked like he was trying to sneak, didn't he? For a man who complains about it. Is it? Oh, maybe it's not in there. Maybe it is not in there. That actually doesn't look like it, does it? It's... Oh, no, I've gone in the wrong place. It's not in Vault 3. It looked like it was in Vault 3. But apparently it might not be. Okay. Ah, well, we killed some fiends. Psh, the world's a better place. There you go. I think, according to the map, we're actually supposed to be heading to the Fiend Shack. Why the hell are we... No, wait a minute. Have I got the quest selected? Yes. Alright, okay. Fair enough. My bad. It's in a shack. Alright, let's just... Really? And that one was like a shoulder shot, but I guess that was enough. Yep, oh well. Such a shame. Terrible waste. The loss of life. Oh, the humanity. And so on. Okay. So... Still heading in the right direction. It's around there. Okay. Well, let's just make sure we deal with.
Nicely done.
Thank you. Huh. It's nice to have an appreciative audience. Another one up there. I stand still. That'll do.
Yeah, fuck 'em.
Also a good sentiment. Okay, we got two of them there. Oh, I like the little jump she did.
Oh, well.
I am doing the world a service just by existing. Saint Jack, that's what they're going to call me. Maybe they'll make a whiskey after me. That'd be cool. I don't really, really need to go off and loot them. I know. That's not something I ever expected to say, but there you go, saying it more and more lately. Okay, have we killed everybody who needs to be killed? No, apparently not. Oh god. Yeah. Wasted a bullet though. It's kind of annoying. Tell you what, should have stuck with. Are you coming? Hello? If we're going long range like that, I should really stick to this weapon. Where are you? I know you're feeling lonely, and I'd like to go and send you to join your friends. Ooh, there's two of them. There's two of them!
Hey, can I ask you a question?
Now?! Fine. What is it?
I wasn't sure if we'd find anything, and now that we're here, I can't help but think of what's going to happen afterwards.
Well, if this conversation
doesn't go
quickly...
For the sake of discussion... Let's say we walk out of that place filthy rich, like Sierra Madre rich. What are you going to do with your cut?
Spend it? Use it to get richer? It's about finishing the job? That's partly the truth as well. I've got so much money now, I almost don't care. But I was thinking of using the money to help... I was just going to piss it away. I wasn't exactly going to do that either, really. I mean, I was probably going to reinvest it, maybe try and open another casino. I like the idea of being filthy rich, but not just rich, wealthy. But more than anything, it is about... No, it's not. No good answers here. Let's focus on getting it first. No, it isn't about the money, it's about finishing the job, he says, sounding like a professional.
It's always about the money. If you want to lie to yourself, say it's not, That's your choice.
No, I'm trying to just sound cool. That's... Yeah, no, I was just... I like money, I like spending it, but I'm not going to piss it away. There was no option that says, I'm going to buy bigger and better guns so that I can shoot things and get more money. Are we done, though? Can we get on with shooting people? My God. Where are they? Yeah, see one. Okay.
Oh, wow.
Now, I think there was at least a second one. I mean, it's probably not essential that we clear this area of fiends. It's kind of nice to know that when we come out of the door, there's not going to be a bunch of them here, though. I think there was another one. No? Well, if there was, he's left. Okay. Plasma repeater? Don't mind if I do. Still want to know where they get these weapons from. Flamer pistol. No, thanks. Ooh, van fuel. That's what that is. Van fuel. And was it worth trying to get up there? Ooh, hello. Nope. I think I've been here before. Didn't I kill one of the fiend bosses in this neighborhood? It looks familiar. Okay, I think this outside area is relatively secure. Now, is that the way in or that the way in? Let's have a look. Look at the local map. There, Fiend Shack and Hank's Transmissions. I'm going to see Hank's Transmissions first. And I want you guys to wait here. Have I been in here before? No. Although I'm taking radiation, so this was Hank Hill. Haven't I been here? I've been here. This is the King of the Hill thing. This is... I seem to be getting... It's probably because I've installed some mods or something and it's respawned certain areas, but I don't remember what those mods were. Could be this inheritance mod, I suppose. Okay. Jack Bryan's Bill. Yeah, you know what? I've read all of this. I've read all of this. We've been here. We've done this. Been there. Done that. Apparently, either didn't loot it or it's repopped. Any of the important caps? Yeah, I'm carrying around. Why am I carrying around? Because I've spent a lot of caps now. Spent a lot of caps. 76,000! I spent a lot of caps. While I was asleep, I did get a message telling me that there is some caps waiting for me back at the casino, back at the Bison Steve Hotel. 2,600 of them, to be precise. Which is rather nice. So we have to go and pick that up sometime soon. Okay, so you guys are going to wait here, and you're...
Good.
You're going to be aggressive. Simple. You, on the other hand... I want you to follow me.
All right, take point.
And I'd like you to be passive, but is it going to work if I ask you to be passive? I'm going to ask you to be passive. All right, so we're going in. Let's see what's in there. Okay. They weren't very observant, were they? See? Doing too many drugs. Don't do drugs, boys. It's bad for you. Trust me. I know these things. Are there any more? Probably. Right, we've got a door down. I'm guessing this is where the entrance to the vault is. Activate the console. That's probably where we're going. And I can't believe these fiends didn't figure out how to do that, so let's assume it is fiend territory down there. And let's also hope we have enough ammo. Requires a key. Okay, that requires a key. Alright, let's go. What do we have here? The Las Vegas Arsenal! Dude. Are you sulking with
what
me?
What is it?
I want to ask you something.
What do you want to know?
Are you annoyed with me? What's your opinion of Mr. House?
There are so many bullshit rumors. I don't know what to think of him. Some ranger told me House drinks his own piss and lives in a test tube. Okay. I've also heard stories of airships, talking death claws, and other nonsense. I tend to be skeptical of these stories. House is in the same category.
Talking death claws sounds daft to me.
Okay, let's get going.
Okay, but are you gonna come this time? Dude? Okay, come on. Am I on my own? Fine. Okay, I'm worried I've broken something now. Enclave. What do we have here?
Stand clear.
Okay, that got Bradley in. That, for some reason, got Bradley in. Okay, that's okay. Right, that's... But it's not getting him to follow me. Oh, God, just... Buh? Okay, Bradley's... Alright. This is a little freaky. Okay. Oh, medical supplies. Always worth it. Medex, empty syringe. Take the lot. And I think I see a doctor's bag. Yes, I do. Sleep in the bed with a skeleton. Let's not do that. Did I see a... No, I don't want to take the chessboard. I want to... Were there any star caps? No. Okay. Lockers. A lot of plasma disruptors. That in itself could be... Make this trip worth it. Toilet. And I'll take that as well. Okay. For some reason the torch is annoying me more than usual. Let's just go for... Hello! My favourite glow. Unfortunately not quite the right type. Oh. Yeah, no, scotch. I got all excited. What have we got here? Produce K. Refrigerator. Cold scotch? That's a bit weird, isn't it? Who puts scotch in the fridge? I suppose. Maybe. I'm going to try that now. Yeah, just for scientific purposes, of course. Right, Is, now we heard. Yes, we did, we heard. So, actually, now that we're in here, and I'm not going to be able to use the long-range weapons, let's get the pulse gun on the, there we go. And this. Pulse gun.
And clear.
Nice
this
of you.
This is now a free life.
Dude. Okay. What, did you just try and punch him? Don't punch him. Do not punch him. Stay passive. Oh, God, you've not... Have you not got...
Of course. Make the Merc carry all
your shit. You've got loads
shit.
Of ammo. You've got ammo. You've got ammo. Stop. You're whining, by the way. You've got ammo. Why were you going to punch him? Okay. Okay, this thing's ridiculously overpowered, isn't it? Forget the pulse slugs. Alright, we got doors. You with me this time? Locked. Average. Not for very long. Okay. I think we should stop worrying about the whole stealth thing. What have we got here? 10mm rounds. Don't mind if I do. Security override terminal. 4 attempts. Come on, where are you? Stunners. Enter. Blah, blah, blah. And read first. Security terminal protocols. Welcome. You have been chosen by our great president to secure and defend the bullion reserves. The bullion reserves stored inside the Las Vegas arsenal. Okay. You will have a number of protectrons at your disposal. Protectrons. Yes. At your disposal, as well as cutting-edge prototype sentry bot. Oh dear. The RY-600. Should a critical malfunction occur, authorized users may power down the RY-600 at this terminal. Yes! Power down! Security log. Logs 1 to 7. Entry 1. I'm just settling in here with Corporal Melville, still getting used to being underground all the time. Judging by the past entries, it seems this log is more of a tool to document drama between personnel here in the reserve. Melvin seems pretty quiet, knows his stuff. Funny, we even brought a few of the same books along. I suppose 6 months sealed in this vault is no worse than the tour in a boomer. God knows it's better than Alaska or Thule. The way things are going out there, maybe we're better off 50 feet under the surface. I got Shelley's letter. Said she and her family bought their way into one of those vaults. I asked Melville if he had a girl or family. He just shook his head. I just hope he isn't some closet psychopath. Some guys crack up when they go without seeing the sun for too long. I performed my initial inspection and everything checks out. Security is online, the entrance is sealed, the vault is secure. I can understand taking extra precautions, but the nerve gas failsafe seems like overkill. It does a little, doesn't it? It's unsettling to know this place is holding enough VX to kill New York. That is very unsettling, yes, Sergeant Henry Budd. Entry 2. Our system picked up the EAM. Locked everything down, the birds are away. Christ, they actually did it. We're both hunkered down, half expecting this place to get caved in. With Nellis, the test site, and Groom Lake. I assumed the Chinese would drop dozens of strategic warheads in and around the city. Only a few distant rumbles, though. Maybe piss-drinking house actually intercepted those birds. Or maybe we're just lucky. Melville stayed in the head, vomiting and sobbing. He has family in Chicago. It's gone now. I have to let that sink in for a moment. I don't know what to feel. I just chain smoke and think about Shelley and hope she's safe. Her last letter mentioned Vault 22. Though I don't know where it is. It doesn't matter, the arsenal is our coffin. Only one of the senior officers from the rig can open this place. And there's not telling when they'll be moving out. It could be decades. So, alright. I never thought I'd be happy that Mom and Dad got in that wreck last year. But at least I know it was quick. Better than lingering on in the hell above us. I keep thinking about the crash, the head-on with the drunk. You're moving along, everything is fine, and then there's a flash of light, a split second of fear and agony, and then it's over. Maybe it's not so different. I'll keep praying for them, and for the others. I hope someone is left to pray for us. Entry 3. It's quiet topside, not even a peep on the sensors. Corporal Melville is still keeping to himself. I think I saw him writing a letter last night. Maybe that's his way of coping with it all. I think about Shelley, what she's doing in the vault. Based on the advertising, you'd think the vault dwellers are better off than they were before the war. It has to be better than it is here, that's for certain. Not if it's Vault 22, mate. At least she's got a family. I keep smoking through the cigarette rations. Maintenance work keeps us both busy, but it's not enough to clear your mind. I tried talking Melville into playing chess, but he refused. He's content to read that Conrad novel, the one set in Africa, so I play by myself. God, I hate the quiet. Happy Halloween. Okay. Today we laughed for the first time since it happened. I was doing inventory, checking the rations, when I slipped on some water. Corporal Melville walked in right as I hit the floor. The fall must have jostled something in my bowels because I farted out loud when I landed. Apparently this is a source of humour for Corporal Melville, who began laughing uncontrollably. I tried to pull rank to make him stop, but stripes don't matter when you're ripping ass. When the fumes finally struck Melvin, I was the one with the last laugh, though. The food should hold out for 50 years, assuming we keep our caloric intake at check. Rationing sucks, but we don't really have a choice. Medical supplies are adequate, but God help us if something serious happens. I've got a bit of first aid training, but I'm no doctor. Melville says he gets squeamish at the sight of blood. I sometimes wonder how he ended up on the surface to begin with. Okay. Thanksgiving, double rations. I might be sick, and we've been getting by on less than 2,000 calories a day, so when we inhale that much freeze-dried turkey and dressing, it's not good. We did the basic checks in the morning, not much else. Robots are running fine, including the Behemoth prototype. Behemoth! Well, I've powered it down. Please tell me I've powered it down. I pity the poor bastard who tries to waltz past that monster. Odd thing happened with Melville yesterday. He was struggling to pull a spanner with his skinny arms. When I reached to help him, our forearms and hands were touching. As I yanked on it, it came free, and I walked off as if nothing happened. Still, I felt strange about it. I'm still awake because of it. Okay. Let's see where this is going. New Year is starting slow. It's a cycle of working, counting, reading, playing chess. We don't talk about the war. We talk about family, friends, childhood memories, everything before it happened. We paint a picture of a world that's still alive. We kid ourselves. I caught some sort of cold and was laid up for a few days last week. Melville stepped up and took over my duties. He also brought me meds and foods. He's a good guy, always looking out for me. He's still writing those letters. We gotta find Melville's letters. They're probably important. I managed to find a couple of gloves and some baseballs down in the storage. It's been great to unwind by playing catch in the halls. It's better than jogging through the facility trying not to get stepped on by the robots. Those goddamn protectrons at a walking cluster. Yeah. Always making a racket, running into stuff when they're on patrol. It seems like we're on a first name basis now. Spirits are picking up a bit. He still won't say what he's writing, but he seems more upbeat about it than before. God help me for writing this, but it's hard to think about Shelley anymore. Josh is the only friend I've got in the world, him and the protectrons. I'm thinking about getting drunk tonight. I managed to find it. No, I did that one. We've done that one. Back. Logs 8 to 14. 8. I feel it is necessary to report my misconduct last night in the interest of good order and discipline. The dire circumstances of my post are no excuse for my behaviour. Last night at roughly 2200 hours, Corporal Joshua Melvin and I became extremely inebriated. Soon thereafter, inappropriate acts and fraternisation took place. This is unbecoming for non-commissioned officer in the United States Army and the Enclave. Under the guidelines of the UCMJ, I have revoked our access to alcoholic beverages, pornography and other entertainment for a period of 1 month. Yes, revoking access to pornography is going to stop that from happening again. Right. Furthermore, we conducted a meeting this morning in which I reiterated the necessity of a chain of command, proper conduct and moral behaviour. We both agreed that our focus should be on our duties. I believe this will bring the matter to a close. Yes, because it's so important. The world has ended, but we must keep up protocols. It happened again. Yesterday, I threw my rank around, blustered about discipline, and tried to pretend it didn't, but it did. The fact is, there may well not be an army up there, or an enclave. It's just me and Josh trapped in this stupid vault. It's probably bound to happen. What bothers me now is how much I liked it. It sure as hell beats being alone. We celebrated our anniversary. I read my old UCMJ report. We both laughed. Baseball, reading, and then wine. That's as good as it gets down here in the arsenal. Josh has kept up with his writing, trying to put some kind of novel together. Sometimes it irritates me because he's so caught up in it, taking time away from me, but it makes him happy. Happiness, not something you would expect down here in this place after the world committed suicide. It's weird, but we've got it. There are fights, but it's hard to stay angry, especially when raised voices get the protectrons worked up. Protectrons! Food stores and medicine are solid. Systems are all green. 2079 has been a good year, all things considered. 10 years, still no noise from above, but everything is running down here. Josh keep tinkering with the endless novel, and I keep playing baseball. At least I've gotten him to play chess, though he insists on winning every game. It's hardly sporting, but these are the things you do for love. We would both give our eye teeth for some fresh literature. We've read Heart of Darkness, Hamlet, and every damned book in here over and over, till we can recite entire chapters from memory. Of course, Josh refuses to let me read a single sentence of his novel. That is weird, isn't it? I know it must sound cliched, but I do miss the sunlight. I think about what it would be like to walk out of here with Josh, taking a stroll back in time. The irony is that we couldn't have made it together in the old world. Josh has been complaining about headaches for a few days, and I don't know what the problem is since I burned through the cigarettes 8 years ago. Maybe we should rotate the mattress. That was that one. 12. The headaches have gotten worse. I've been managing the maintenance for a week, all while taking care of him. The only thing that helps the pain is morphine, and I'm worried about getting him hooked. We've only got so much of it to go around. I think there's an old auto dock somewhere in the storage. I'm going to dig it out and see if I can rig it up to give him an examination. It's just a headache. It will pass. It's Christmas Eve and Josh is dying. I've been with him for a week now. I've been by him for a week now. Auto dock detected an inoperable brain tumour, malignant. I'm rationing the morphine so he doesn't hurt. He's not even himself anymore, just delirious. I thought we'd get old together, that there would be more time. It wasn't enough to end the world, was it, God? Okay. Sod you and all your infinite wisdom. I keep saying I love you, but I can't tell if he can understand me. Christ, just let it end. Final entry. I found the last pack of cigarettes hidden in this old desk. I think Josh was trying to hide them from me back when he was policing my health. He passed last night, just before the morphine was going to run out. I guess that was God's token gesture. I'm going to make the gesture of my own right after this smoke. 10mm should do the trick. I'm putting the bots on high alert in case any of those people come in here. This place should have been buried back in 77, and I should have been buried with it. Oh, well. Okay. There you go. Okay, well, that kind of sucked, I suppose. Although, it's kind of a love story. There's the pistol. So where's Josh? Who died in his bed. Okay, that clipping really is kind of annoying me. Alright. Is that... Okay. That is the RY-600. Which we disabled, thankfully, as that good? Yeah, okay, still not found Josh. Is Josh not really dead? He's actually a ghoul or something. I'll tell you what, I think I'm going to use the pulse gun from now on robots and have this ready in case we meet ghouls. No, he did. He died, didn't he? He died of a brain tumour. We've not found his... Maybe we found it earlier and I didn't notice it. Okay. What are they? I'm hearing... Okay, no turrets. Does this look... This looks ominous, doesn't it? Does this look ominous to you? This looks ominous to me. Okay.
Fuck! Okay. Somebody just sealed that door up. We're trapped in this motherfucker.
Oh.
I think someone's using the intercom. Go ahead and see what these assholes want.
Why don't you talk on the intercom? Why? Okay, we got three doors. We got three doors. Inaccessible. have here? Inaccessible, and we've got... I'm guessing that's inaccessible. We've got an ammo store, which does... My God, does this have boss fight written all over it, or what? Okay. We're gonna need... oh, good grief. What are we getting? We got a mini nuke? What are we expected to fight in here? Oh, brilliant. Okay. Alright, come here. You need ammo.
Don't even think about touching my rifle.
I'm giving you ammo, you idiot. Five? Oh, God, we've still got... You've got six, mind you. You're pretty good. You do quite a lot of damage. That's all I got. Okay. Is it going to be a robot, do you think? It's going to be a robot, isn't it? It's going to be a robot. Is it going to come through the ceiling? All right.
Ah, the Intrepid Explorers! Let me just say, it's been a pleasure tracking your adventures. Some close calls. You even found places we didn't know about. Truly, commendable.
Oh, I don't like you already. I really, really, really don't like you. Yeah, who the hell are you, and why are you locking us in here?
Name is Zimmer.
Sounds familiar.
I'm a representative for a certain organization which has a stake in this vault.
Yeah, the Syndicate, with a fancy name. Yeah. I'm going to kill you.
That would be a twist.
It's going to be, and I'm going to kill you. You're the Syndicate. Fine. You're with the Syndicate,
really,
aren't you?
It's only a name. Some people call it the outfit, our thing. Don't read into it too much.
I'm not.
Just a group of businessmen with shared interests.
In the shared future. That future being... no head. What do you want?
It's pretty simple. We want the gold and weapons sealed up in those vaults.
You can't have
them. It belongs to us. I suppose Sellers neglected to mention that little caveat. You and Mr. Bradley were kind enough to lead my scouts here, and perhaps... I respect your commitment, so I offer you this. I will let one of you leave. Right now.
What?
Who leaves is entirely up to you and Bradley. I should inform you that my hacker friend is taking control of the security systems. I can fill that chamber with nerve gas in under a minute. Who would have thought that a fiend hacker could be so capable? I swear, they come from all walks of life. It never ceases to amaze me.
Why would you do that? What sort of twisted individual are you?
Things? Well, just say the word, and you can huff some VX. I hear it does wonders for the sinus pressure.
Why one of us? Why not kill both of us or let both of us go?
Don't consider any trickery. Kill or be killed. Just as it should be.
You're a twisted... It's me, the guy's coming. The guy, why do... I am going to eat your heart. Yeah, this one.
Easy, courier. I've got a fiend up here with delicate sensibilities. You wouldn't want to offend him, right? Why don't you save all that aggression and angst for Mr. Bradley?
Because I like Mr. Bradley. You, on the other hand,
I don't want to do this, but... Fuck me, I'm sorry.
Well, don't do it. Do not do it. Put down the weapon, and we'll find a way out of this. I'm sorry to... No. I'm sick of you whining like a... I'm not. I like his whining. It's cool. Look, flip a coin. No, we're not flipping a coin. Look, seriously. We stick together. We find a way to blow the door open, you idiot.
No. I'm not going to get gassed like a fucking insect.
Oh!
I'd rather go out with a weapon in my hands. Sorry, courier.
Oh, you... You... idiot!
I'll see you on the other side, courier.
As long as you get there... Oh! No! Okay, alright, seriously? I've got a pulse gun in my hand! I've got a pulse gun in my hand! Okay. Fine. Whiskey. Rocket. Rushing water. And slasher.
Ah, the Intrepid Explorer.
Oh, shut. Oh.
Name.
I am going to kill you. You're with the Syndicate,
really?
Aren't you? Blah, 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 blah. Why do bad guys like to just keep talking? yada, yada, yada. I'm going to eat your heart. And so...
Fuck, I don't want to do this, but... Fuck me, I'm sorry.
You're an idiot, Bradley.
No. I'll see you on the other side, courier.
Soon after Bradley crumples to the floor, you hear Zimmer chortling through the intercom, followed by the shutter of the door as the locks turn. So I can get out now. Idiot. Fine. Oh, that really did suck. That totally and utterly sucked. Can I get out of here now? Can I get through these doors? I want all this gold and stuff. So why is this guy let me out anyway? He's got to know I'm coming to kill him. He's got to know that. As the metallic crash of the door registers from behind, you realise the hub will now be inaccessible. It will behoove you to search the shack for information regarding the Syndicate's whereabouts. I will. Oh, you mean they're not even in this place? They were doing all that remotely? Search the shack. So this was Josh's area, wasn't it? Right, okay, what's that? Buff out. Was this Josh's whereabouts? Is that Josh? Yeah, okay. Stand, IV stand, blood pack. No, I'll leave that there. Alright, that's Josh. Alright. Are any of these his book? No? Chessboard. Dining room set up for them. Oh dear. I am really annoyed about having to kill him. Okay, is there anyone up here? That really is depressing. Search the shack. Can I get in there yet? Okay. So this is the control area. This is where they were sat. Open desk. You killed him. More drugs. Mentats. Oh. Well, you had it coming, mate. You had it coming. Because I was going to kill you if he didn't. Billy, someone offered Shulgin. Somebody offed Shulgin. So most of the group are drifting back to the ruins around Vault 3. Lucky for us, the outfit keeps supplying a lot of jet for odd jobs. They mainly wanted to keep pressure on Westside, though he said not to get carried away. Just hold-ups, kidnappings, and the occasional murder. He also said to let the militia use the worst junkies for target practice. As long as the dope is flowing, I'm down for anything. I'm going to push off tonight. You're welcome to join in. Ever get high and watch Eileen work a prisoner? Crazy shit, man. Jeez. My name's called Jack. Are you kidding me? P.S. If you need extra work, just talk to Hastings over the thorn. Big Bastard has some juicy contracts with the outfit. He can hook you up. See you later. Hastings at the Thorn. I guess we know where we're going next. Completed. Search for clues regarding the Syndicate's location. Optional. Inform Hastings that your business with the Syndicate is finished. Speak with Hastings about finding Zimmer. Quests. Let me read that again. Optional. Speak with Hastings about finding Zimmer. Optional. Inform Hastings that your business with the Syndicate is finished. Oh, no, no, no. No, 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 no. My business with the Syndicate has only just started.
Yippee-yay, there'll be no wedding bells for today.